السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، حبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الغر الميامين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. We thank Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us this opportunity to have these very important discussions on preparations to welcome the holy month of Ramadan. The month of Allah, the month of blessings, the month of seeking nearness to our beloved merciful creator, a month within which each and every one of us expected to strengthen his or her relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're going to have serious discussions how to prepare for these great guests of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala known as Shahru Ramadan. In this first episode, our discussion will focus the name of this great month, which is Shahrullah. When you go through that beautiful sermon of our beloved prophet in welcoming the holy month of Ramadan, the holy prophet referred to this month as Shahrullah. So I thought it's important to unlock meaning of Shahrullah, or why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relates this holy month to himself. No doubt, the holy month of Ramadan has so many names. The traditions we received from our beloved Ahlul Bayt, alayhim afdalu salati wa aska salam. And the first name, as I mentioned, it is from that tradition which Sheikh Saduq reported from Imam Ja'far Sadiq, alayhi salam, and all Imams, including Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen, that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam rendered a sermon on a day. Right from the beginning of that sermon, he said, Ayyuhan nasu, innahu kad akbala ilaykum shahrullah. O people, indeed, the month of Allah is approaching. The month of Allah is coming to you. Some of the names given to this month, as per the traditions, is Shahrullah al-Akbar, the greatest month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or Shahru Diyafatillah, the month of Allah's hospitality. Meaning this is a month where all of us are going to be hosted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some call it Shahru Nuzul al-Quran, the month of the revelation of the glorious Quran. Or Shahru Tilawat al-Quran, the month of the recitation of Quran. And of course, the common name is Shahru Siyam, the month of fasting. Or Shahru al-Islam, the month of Islam, in the sense that in this month, whatever act of worship I and you undertake, it defines the Islamic teachings, the usul and the furu'. And of course, another name for this month is Shahru Tuhur, the month of self-purification, or Shahru Tamhisi, the month of scrutiny, whereby you scrutinize yourself to be able to discover who truly you are. Or the month of Istighfar, another name of this month, as per the traditions we received from Ahlul Bayt, alayhim as-salam. Shahru Dua, that's also another name for the holy month of Ramadan, the month of supplication, the month of Dua. Or Shahru Ta'a, the month of obedience, meaning it is a moment we are all expected to be obedient to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And last but not least, name for this beautiful month is Shahru Al-Ibadah, the month of worship. Now, as I said, our discussion, this first episode, is to look at why this month is called Shahrullah. the month of Allah, or Shahrullah al-Akbar, the greatest month of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you go through the traditions of the Prophet and Ahlul Bayt, you realize that there are so many traditions referring to this month as the month of Allah Azza wa Jal. For example, a tradition was reported from the wife of the Holy Prophet that the Holy Prophet said, Shahru Ramadan, Shahrullah. The month of Ramadan is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa shahru sha'ban shahri. And the month of Sha'ban is my month. And then of course, you know, the hadith continued, Sha'banul mutahhir wa Ramadanul mukaffir. That Sha'ban is a month that purifies us. And Ramadan is a month that takes away and dissolves all our sins. Another tradition from Abi Abdullah al-Sadiq alayhi salam, our beloved Chief Imam, annahu qal, Imam Sadiq said, the Holy Prophet mentioned, Shahru Ramadan, Shahrullah. The month of Ramadan is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is Rabi'ul Fuqara. It is the spring of the needy and those who are really struggling in their lives. And of course, you've got tradition from our beloved Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, annahu qal, Imam Ali said, Shahru Ramadan, Shahrullah, wa Shahban, Shahru Rasulillah, sallallahu alayhi wa ali, wa Rajab Shahri. Indeed, the month of Ramadan is the month of Allah, and Shahban is the month of the Holy Prophet, and Rajab is my month, according to Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen, salawatullahi wa salamu wa alayhi. Now question. Why is this month called the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? There are two reasons. The first reason is that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala pays special attention to his servants, most especially those who observe the fast in this month. And under the same reason, scholars said, called the month of Allah simply because this month is so dear to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah cherishes this month. And Allah loves this month. And this is like what Allah says in glorious Quran. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي أَنِّي. That Ya Rasulullah, when my servant come to you concerning me. Allah in this verse said, my servant, relating the servant to him. Meaning what? He's got a special attention to that servant. Likewise, he said, Shahri, my month. Meaning what? This month is so dear to Allah, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala pays special attention to his servant in this month. And then the second reason as to why this month is called the month of Allah, according to some scholars, because Ramadan is one of the names of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is why you have a tradition from Imam al-Bakir alayhi salam, that when you call this month, don't say Ramadan. Because if you say Ramadan, like you are not paying utmost respect to this name, which is regarded as one of the names of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hence, Imam al-Bakir alayhi salam would say, do not say Hada Ramadan. Don't say this is Ramadan, or wala dhahaba Ramadan. Don't say Ramadan is gone, is finished. And do not say ja'a Ramadan, Ramadan has come. Because Ramadan ismun min asma'illahi ta'ala. That Ramadan is one of the names of Allah. And Allah does not come, and Allah does not go, and Allah has no end. Walakin qulu shahru Ramadan. But say, the month of Ramadan. So if the month is referred to as the month of Allah, then there is no doubt it requires a great deal of preparation. And that is what we will be discussing in the coming episodes. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.